Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is this system is here. We know X of N input, we know Y of N output, that we don't know this impulse response. How do we know this H of N impulse response? This is concept of, I said many times, impulse response. Okay, in previous lecture, I explained we know input X of N and the impulse we know, then we can get like this. Output is convolution by X of N input and impulse response. This. Today's topic is this. We know this, then we don't know this. And how to know this? For this, let me consider this one. That one means we are using this kind. As input, we are using delta function. Instead of this, we are using this one. Then from this, if we know this one, then also we can calculate y of n. But let's calculate output y of n. Okay, then y of n equals input that of n convolution h of n, okay? Then from this summation m equal minus infinite infinite that of m h n minus m, okay? What is this value? Let me think. This one, what is this one? That of n. Now here, delta function means this. Delta function here, n equal 0, amplitude equal 1, another place is all 0, okay? Therefore here, delta function means m equal 0, the signal magnitude equal 1. M is not equal to 0, all function 0. Therefore, just that we have m equal 0. Delta m h n minus 0. Okay? Then this value is 1, therefore h n. Okay, what is the result? We can get output equals to impulse response. Okay? Now one more time, impulse response h of n equal output. Okay, when we use the delta function as input, instead of x n, we use delta function. Okay, then we can get output function from this output same as equals to impulse response like this. Okay. We call this, we are using the impulse function, meaning that of n, as an input, we can get response output. That means impulse response equals output. Okay? Impulse response output. This is impulse response is output. Same. When input signal is impulse signals, therefore x n equals to, we using the del of n instead of x of n, then we can get y of n equals to h of n. This is impulse response. Okay? And some examples. Let me take some examples here. Okay? Now, this. Now you can find here x of n, x n minus 2, n minus 2. Instead of this, we can use that of n. Also, instead of this, that of n minus 2. Instead of this, that of n minus 4. Okay? Then we can rewrite h of n. H of n. H of n equal 0.1 that of n minus 0.3 that of n minus 2 plus 0.2 2 derobo and minus 4, right? Oh, this is impulse response. Okay, this is impulse response. Okay, see? And also we can represent the graph. Now graph means this is n here, and equal 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then this means n equals 0, amplitude equal 0.1. This is 0.1. And this is n equals 2, the amplitude equal minus 0.3. Minus 0.3. This means n equals 4, amplitude equal 0.2. This is 0.2. This is 0, 0 is okay. This is also h of n we showed in graphically. Also, we can represent the sequential type. H of n equal 0.1, and next 0, next minus 0.3, next 0, next 0.2, we call this. This is a sequential type, okay? Okay, we call this for representing the impulse response like this. We can show you can use the equations, graph, and the sequence type. You can do. Now here, pay attention to these parts. Okay, one more time. Then here, how many signals are there? There are 5. Okay, 5 means finite value. Therefore, the number of signal in this case is just five signals. Therefore, in this case, we can say finite impulse response. Okay, finite impulse response. Finite means the number of sequence, the numbers of these signals are finite, in this case 5. We call this finite impulse response. Okay. Next, how about this? Now pay attention to this. Number 2. Now you can see this kind. This one. Why n minus 1 is here? This is a past output. Okay, past output. Also, instead of x of n, you can use derobo and instead of this derobo n minus 2. Okay, this means instead of this you can use this is h n minus 1. Okay, then h of n, please. Now h of n equals 0.1 derobo n minus 0.3 derobo n minus 2 plus 0.1 h n minus is coming. So, okay. Then what is the h n minus 1? Okay. This. It is. This means, you can say one more time. H n equal to h n minus 1 means 0.1 derobo n minus 1. Instead of this, we can use n minus 1, okay? Minus 0.3 derobo n minus 3 plus 0.1 also here h n minus 2 shows, okay? Then also, what is this value? What is this one? This one also, you can say, this one is, this one also, 0.1 derobo n minus 2 plus 0.3 derobo n minus 4 plus 0.1 also, h n minus short. Like this, this term short continuously to infinite. Okay. Therefore, what we can say is the number of signals of ACN is infinite. Okay, infinite. Means it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 go to infinite. This infinite. Therefore, in this case, we can say compared to this one, like now, okay, now, okay. Now, this one, and we call this infinite. Infinite impulse response compared to this. Okay, in this case, finite. In this case, infinite. Why you know the infinite and finite? Okay, this number. The number of the impulse response is infinite. Then, also from this, we cannot represent H of N. We cannot represent this one. Then, what shall we do? How to know this impulse response? We cannot know? No. Okay, from this, we need G transform. G transform. If you need this, H over G is Y over G by X over G. You can, from this, you can know the impulse response. Same as this one. About this, let me explain later in my lecture. Okay. Today, thank you very much for your watching. Today, I explained we know this, and how to know this. How to obtain the impulse response. Now, I already explained to you H of N is output. Output is Y of N. When X of N equals that of N, we call this, from this we can know the Y of N. Okay. Next topic, let me explain the properties of systems. Properties of systems, memory or memoryless, causal systems. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.